and unprecedented quarantine in Wuhan and central China and nearby cities in lockdown.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. I greet you with Assalamu Alaikum Warahmatullahi Wabarakatuh here in my sitting room in my native island of Trinidad in the Caribbean. And I have so far hesitated to offer a mature opinion about the virus and the universal lockdown around the world, which is an absolutely unique phenomenon in human history. It never happened before. That all the masajid around the world, illa masha'Allah, are locked down. That there is no Salatul Jummah everywhere in the world. No Salatul Jummah, illa masha'Allah. This never happened before in human history. Correct me, please, if I'm wrong. I don't have any shortage of critics. But this is my opinion, that this is an absolutely unique phenomenon in history, and therefore it needs to be analyzed. The Quran has declared that it has been sent down tibyanan li kulli shay, to explain all things. Ba'adhu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim. Wa nazzalna 'alayka al-kitaba tibyanan li kulli shay wa hudan wa rahmatan wa bushra lil muslimin. That Allah has sent down this Quran on thee, O Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, that this Quran might explain all things. And so what is the explanation of what's happening in the world today? This is my explanation. Because I have been pioneering Islamic eschatology for 20 years now, while the Darul Ulooms around the world have been closing their doors on me and closing the doors of the masajid to me. Yes, they have been doing that. Now look at their position. My analysis, alhamdulillah, is credible. The Dajjal is the mastermind. He has given us a dramatic and an absolutely stunning demonstration of his capacity at this time to rule the world. That's what's happening today. And the virus is simply the means through which he has demonstrated that capacity. If he can do it with the virus, what is coming after the virus? That's a good question. And today I'm going to offer to you my analysis, my initial analysis. There's more to come after this. But I think the most important area for us to direct our attention to in the post-virus world is the economy and money. I believe there is a more opportunity for Dajjal to advance his agenda with an attack on money rather than an attack on other things in the economy. And so I'm expected that this vast bubble of fake money, bogus and fraudulent and utterly haram, fake money, this vast bubble is going to bust in the post-virus world. And when it busts, absolutely what's going to happen is economies are going to collapse. Why? Because the value of money is going to collapse. It's called hyperinflation, runaway inflation. And so what do? In order to avoid descending into slavery, what do? I have been advising for more than 20 years now, that we must follow the guidance in Surah Al-Kahf of the Quran. In Surah Al-Kahf of the Quran, the Ashab Al-Kahf, the young men, fled from the city and they went to the cave, and they stopped in the cave for a while because they were on their way, I believe, to the remote countryside where there's more security. And they stopped in the cave for a while, and Allah put them to sleep for 300 years. And Allah says in the Quran, وَإِذِ اَتَزَلْتُمُوهُمْ وَمَا عَبُدُونَ إِلَّا اللَّهَ فَأُوْ إِلَى الْكَهْفِ يَنْشُرْ لَكُمْ رَبُّكُمْ مِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ إِلَى آخِرِ الْآيَةِ. So there is Allah's protection, there's Allah's blessing, there's Allah's rahmah, if we were to now leave the cities and go to the remote countryside. And this is the time, if you have any savings, take it out of the bank. Don't keep it in paper, because tomorrow you can't buy anything. This is the time, if you have any savings, to put it in land and putting it in animals, more important than gold and silver. Put it in land and put it in animals. Keep a little bit of silver for buying and selling daily things. But put your savings in land and in animals. Create small communities in the remote countryside which are self-sufficient. It doesn't have to be an exclusive Muslim village. That's a mistake I made. It has to be a village of people who want to live the religious way of life, who want to live lives of righteousness, and who would live together as a family. So the Hindu who is prepared to live with a Muslim as a family in India, the Christian who is prepared to live with a Muslim as family members in the Balkans, reach out to them and get together and live together as small communities which are self-sufficient. You must have water, you must have your own food, you must produce your own crops, your own milk and meat and salt. This is my initial advice to you at this time. There's more to come. Just warning you, that this is Dajjal at work. The Maulanas and the Muftis who shut the doors on me, they don't talk about Dajjal. I am talking about it. This is Dajjal at work. This absolutely stunning demonstration of his capacity to rule the world. That's what's happening now. And I anticipate that as this virus attack is coming to an end, at that time we're going to expect the collapse of money. So do please prepare yourself for that in advance and take appropriate steps. The Prophet said, if you have land, hold on to the land. If you have animals, hold on to the animals. Thank you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.